Hey everyone, today I'm gonna go ahead and share five of my favorite chapter books to read aloud in grades kindergarten, first, and second grade. In the primary grades, we tend to focus a lot on those picture books, and don't get me wrong, I have a huge place in my heart for all sorts of picture books, and I read those way more often than I do chapter books, but I always want to make sure that I'm giving students opportunities to listen to and participate discussing different chapter book texts. There are gajillions of different chapter books you can read aloud to your students, so today I just wanted to focus on five different ones. Some are newer, some are older classics, and I'm gonna give you a little bit of information about each one and why I love to read it in a primary classroom. In case you are new here, my name is Susan Jones. I am a former K-2 literacy teacher and first grade classroom teacher who is getting their master's in curriculum instruction and spending a lot of time here on YouTube sharing ideas with teachers like you. By the end of this video, hopefully you will have five new book ideas to read aloud with your classroom. And if you stick to the end, I even have a little freebie for you. So let's get started. All right, before I dive into a little bit about each book, I do want to let you know that I have spent time, if I have put these books on this little list that I have here, that means I have read and reread them numerous times with my students, either as a whole group classroom or when I was in a K-2 literacy teacher position, I did pull out. So I would do them in small groups as well. Some of these are fantastic to run book clubs with. And also, if you've been following me for a while, you might know that I have an interactive read aloud unit for picture books that looks like this. And I've also made a chapter book version with about 13 or 14 of my favorite chapter books that I plan to add to. So all of these chapter books list that I'm going to share today, they are included in that interactive read aloud unit. It looks like this. And actually I'll show you with this first one a little bit about what's included because it includes some of the questions that I like to ask when you read that book and vocabulary, things like that. So let's dive into book number one. All right, starting us off at number one is an old classic that I just love. It is called My Father's Dragon by Ruth Stiles Gannett. This is a classic book about a young boy named Elmer who travels to a forbidden island to save an abused dragon. My students love to follow along Elmer's journey of fantasy as they try to guess how he's going to outsmart each dangerous animal that he comes across. When I'm reading this book aloud to my class, we talk a lot about problems and solutions because he comes across all of these different dangerous animals while he's on his adventure, and we discuss character traits as we try to decide what type of character Elmer is throughout the story. I really love reading this book aloud to my students because of the fantasy aspect of it, and I find that it's really, really engaging for them. And I like the way that it's set up too. I mentioned problem and solution. Basically, within most of the chapters, if not all of them, it starts off with a very clear problem, and then Elmer figures out how to solve the problem, and there's a solution at the end. There's also a problem and solution throughout the entire story with the abused dragon as well. So it's a great book to point out that problem and solution structure, as well as have students make predictions about how Elmer might solve each of these problems. Each and every read aloud lesson is set up just like this. Here's the first page. I always have a little preview that you can actually read aloud to the students. At the end, you can see it says, as I read, I want you to think of what kind of character traits Elmer shows and how you may be able to relate to any of his experiences. Then I point out different key vocabulary and what page it is found. And then for my chapter books, you can see I go ahead and list out the questions from each chapter that I would stop and ask my students. So if you're familiar with my picture book read aloud, these are set up in a very similar way. And I have read this book so many times, all the books many, many times. And I go through and try to find the best questions at each of these stopping points after each chapter to ask students. Now, because chapter books tend to be a lot longer than picture books, I also came up with a lot more questions that you could ask that looks like this. So for each of the books here, I have some lower order questions as well as some higher order questions to ask after each chapter. I love putting these in there because if we're doing a book club, this allows all of my first grade, second grade, kindergarten even students to attend to the book and engage with the book, even depending on their level, right? Some students might be able to answer some more higher order questions and dig a little deeper into the text, and some students might be okay practicing those lower order questions. And then of course I have some end of book questions as well. Now with that vocabulary that I pointed out at the beginning, I make a vocabulary sheet like this There's actually two of them in here to cover all the vocabulary that I point out. And here students have to match up the definition to the word, and then they will go ahead, complete each sentence with one of the vocabulary words and try to write their own sentence below. After vocabulary, we go into comprehension, and I do have two levels of a little comprehension book as well for each book. Here's an example of a lower level book. So here they would be drawing the beginning, middle, and ending of the story. They would draw the main character and think of two words to describe them. They would point out a problem and solution, and they would identify their favorite part of the story. And lastly, think of an animal Elmer came across in My Father's Dragon and explained what happened in that scene. Many of the same questions would be included in the higher level version. It looks like this. Here they have lines to retell the major events from beginning, middle, and end of the story. Here they're going to think of two adjectives to describe Elmer and give an example from the text for each adjective. So you can see how that's a little more involved than in the lower level book. Here, same problem and solution, favorite part, and this one, a higher order thinking question. I have them wondering what is one thing you would have done differently from Elmer on this adventure, and they need to explain why. So because I like to use all these chapter books with grades kindergarten, first, second grade, and sometimes even third graders, this allows my students of all different levels to be able to engage with the text, which I love. Lastly, all of the read aloud lessons also include ready-made writing prompts, so three for each. So for My Father's Dragon, these are the questions I like to ask. What should Elmer and the dragon do now? Write their next adventure below. Elmer must have been nervous when he arrived on Wild Island, but he overcame his nerves to save the dragon. Can you think of a time you overcame your nerves to do something great? And Elmer invaded the animal's home on Wild Island and took something they had been using for years. Do you think it was okay for him to steal the dragon? Why or why not? So if you happen to read My Father's Dragon anytime soon, feel free to pause the video, jot those down, go back, look at the vocabulary, look at everything I put up here, pause it, use it however you need. All right, chapter book number two is one of my own boys' personal favorites. They giggle and giggle and love reading this series of books. It is by Kate DiCamillo, and it is called Mercy Wasson to the Rescue. This one is definitely geared towards the younger grades, and my students, actually in kindergarten, first, and second grade, just think that Mercy Wasson is hilarious. She is the pig here. She is the main character in a series of books. I actually believe there's about six of them, but here in her first adventure, she saves the day pretty accidentally because she is searching all over for some yummy toast. So when we read this colorful book, we talk a lot about cause and effect, and we also compare the different characters that we read and meet in this story. I tell you, my copy of Mercy Wasson is so well loved by my boys. The colorful illustrations and the silly little story, they love it. They love all six in this series. Chapter book number three I love to read is The Chocolate Touch by Patrick Catling. This book follows along the story of John Midas, a little boy who loves chocolate so much that one day everything he touches turns to chocolate. Yes, it sounds a lot like the myth, the Midas touch, but my younger students love the fantasy aspect of this. They love thinking about everything turning to chocolate because they, you know, tend to love chocolate. And my older students, we definitely read the myth, the Midas touch, and compare notes. While I read this story with my class, we definitely focus on theme, and we also talk a lot about character changes. This is such a fun one. This is such a fun one. This is such a fun one. Why did I do this so many times? All right, get the tissues ready for number four. This one is definitely geared towards older students, and it is The One and Only Ivan by Catherine Applegate. Now, I definitely say this book is geared towards older students because of the topics it talks about. This is a novel that follows animal abuse through the eyes of Ivan, who is the main character, the gorilla in the story. Basically, he lives what he thinks is a wonderful life at the mall behind glass doors all day. And it's not until he meets a new little friend, Ruby, that he starts to question where he's living and if it's best for him and other animals. In the story, Ivan decides to make change for the better, and it really is a beautiful story that students really feel when I read it out loud to them. The vocabulary can be quite difficult in this book, but it does not take away from the meaning and message of the story. If you have not read this with your students, you should definitely preview this text first, read through it. It's a beautiful read even as an adult, and assess kind of the maturity of your classroom and if you think it would be appropriate for them. But it's just so beautiful that I had to share it with you guys. And I've definitely read it with groups of second graders, so. All right, on to chapter book number five that I love for primary students. We are talking about Jaden Toussaint the Greatest, and this one is written by Marty Dumas. This is another series, and it's about Jaden Toussaint, who is a very smart kindergartner. and he gets to use his dad's iPhone once and becomes hooked on technology. So obviously this is a relatively new book, but he tries in the book to desperately need more screen time, and he tries different ways to kind of get that. I think it was published in 2015, and so many of my students can relate to young Jaden and his quest for screen time. The story is written in a very graphically appealing way. You can see here with fun illustrations and labels that help us learn a lot more about Jaden and his family throughout the story. There are also tons of good vocabulary words in here, and students are excited to see if by the end of the story, Jaden is successful in his quest. As we read, we focus on retelling the story, making comparisons between the main character and ourselves, and we focus on Jaden's character traits. This is episode one. I believe there are 6 different episodes in Jaden's storyline and his series. They're not all about screen time. In each different one, he kind of has his own little quest. So this is where your freebie comes in. I showed you all of those pages for My Father's Dragon earlier. I actually have an entire interactive read aloud unit, like I said, for each of the chapter books, but the one for Jaden Toussaint is completely for free that I will link down in the description below. It has all of those vocabulary word pages. It has the comprehension booklets, the page read alouds. It has everything in there for you to have a highly successful read aloud unit or book club kind of going on with your students, whole group or small group, up to you. So grab your copy down in the description and let me know what you think. Also, let me know, were any of these chapter books new to you? Have you already read these in your classroom? What do you think? I already know there are so many other chapter books out there in this world to read with your kids. Please let me know your favorites down in the comments. I have an ever-growing list of chapter books that I love to read and add to my list. And as my own kids are finally getting older, we're still very much in the picture book phase, but I'm already building up their library for when they are in the chapter book phase. So drop your favorite titles down in the comments. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and give me a thumbs up so I know. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel and click that bell. That way you get notified of every new video. See you next time.